One of my theories about workplace bullying is that it is a form of narcissistic abuse. So all workplace bullies are narcissists, or at the very least, have very narcissistic tendencies. Now, narcissistic personality disorder is an actual mental health condition that's in the DSM. So workplace bullies are, by definition, mentally ill. But the mental illnesses of workplace bullies go way beyond NPD. Workplace bullies bully for a number of different reasons. They bully because they're just miserable people. They bully because they're emotionally immature and, above all, pathologically jealous. But they also bully because they're sick, not only psychologically, but also physically. How do you know workplace bullies are clinically insane? Please, it's so obvious even Stevie Wonder could see it, and it don't take Miss Cleo with the crystal ball to see just how sick these people really are. Just look at their behavior. No reasonably normal, sane, healthy human being with an IQ of over about 80 on the face of the planet Earth would dream of engaging in any of these people's behaviors. But another one of my theories about workplace bullying is that most often the target of workplace bullying is an empath, or at the very least, a highly sensitive person. If you are intuitive and sensitive, and you are clairsentient on top of that, you know these people are mentally ill because you can pick up and feel their mental health conditions inside your own body. Just one day after sitting next to your suicidally depressed coworker, you're on the phone with your psychiatrist trying to get medication for yourself. To be a clairsentient empath who absorbs other people's negativity into your own body in a workplace bullying environment is interesting, to say the least. I will spare you the gory details, but suffice it to say, if you are an empath in a workplace bullying environment, you know where every toilet is within a 10-mile radius. As I stated, the mental illnesses of workplace bullies go way beyond narcissistic personality disorder. Very common in the workplace bullying population is bipolar disorder, often bipolar 1. That's the kind that throws and breaks things. Some of these people may indeed be schizophrenic, and you don't want to know who hears voices in their head telling them that you are dangerous and they need to hurt you. And to medicate all of their pre-existing depression and anxiety, there are, of course, the addictions. It's obvious who's addicted to cigarettes and or food, and even alcohol, because some workplace bullies go so far as to drink on the job during their lunch breaks and often show up hungover with that whole puffy, beady-eyed, greasy, stringy, unwashed, uncombed look. And some workplace bullies may be mixing prescription medication because, let's face it, when it comes to drugs, illegal drugs are out and prescription meds are in with alcohol, which you're not supposed to do. And you know they're doing that because they get this particularly hard, glaring glint in their eye. Why are these people so sick? Well, in order to understand the origin of their dysfunction, all you have to do is look at their dysfunctional families of origin. If workplace bullies, as narcissists who are so precious about their image and reputation, are trying to keep things close to their chest and hide their glaring mommy and daddy issues, they're not doing a very good job. They really lay all their cards on the table. It's obvious. It is their childhood rape, incest, molestation, and sexual, physical, emotional, psychological abuse, abandonment, and neglect, or just invalidation. And because workplace bullies are completely untreated and unhealed and improperly medicated, their toxicity extends into their immediate families, because let's face it, if this is how they treat their coworkers, imagine how they treat people in their personal life, including their family members. It's obvious who's having marital issues, spending way too much time in the office in order to avoid going home to the spouse, and may even speak relatively openly with thinly veiled sarcasm at work about their marriage problems. A word now about the children of workplace bullies. They pop in and out of the workplace from time to time, or show up at social gatherings outside of the workplace, because people who are bullying you will introduce you to their loved ones at the same time. When it comes to the children of workplace bullies, this is something that is just sad. All children are natural empaths until decades of social programming beat their intuition out of them, to make them dependent and therefore controllable. So children are not only empathic sponges, but also empathic mirrors. They are deeply attuned to the emotional timbre of any environment they're in and reflect perfectly the toxicity of their narcissistic parents. The children of workplace bullies know exactly what kind of people their parents really are. The small ones, the preteens, are just sad. The adolescents are angry. And if workplace bullies are old enough, their adult children are just screwed up. It's heartbreaking. I've always found it interesting that a toxic work environment is almost always characterized by toxic food. Processed American junk loaded with known poisons and toxins, a workplace bullying environment is Dorito land. Vending machine snacks and microwave meals filled with sodium, high fructose corn syrup, and chemicals that you can't pronounce. If, just as you are not into the bullying, you're not really into all the crap food and go so far as to prepare fresh, healthy meals for yourself at home, or just have a habit of drinking your RDA of quality water every day, because of do-gooder derogation, they will bully you for that too. Using the workplace bullying mantra, are you ready for it? Here we go, let's do this. You think you're better, you think you're all that, and appropriately, a bag of chips. Who do you think you are? Blah, blah, blah. Why do workplace bullies bully? Well, just physically, they don't feel very good. A workplace bullying environment is the food wars. Workplace bullies are obsessed with your food. And because they are so competitive about everything, they will try to compete with you about that too. It's all about who has the fanciest designer cheese. Yes, it really does get that petty. And after the workplace bullying food wars, we can do the workplace bullying sleep wars, otherwise known as the I'm up at five jerk. I'm up at five. Workplace bullies brag about how little sleep they get as though they deserve a merit badge for it, because these are people who do not know how to work smart. They work hard, not smart. And if you appear well rested, which means that you have a youthful appearance, they will bully you for that too and accuse you of being lazy. Meanwhile, they don't brag about other unhealthy lifestyle choices. For example, eating McDonald's for breakfast, lunch, and dinner, and never going to the gym. The craziness of mentally ill workplace bullies is ironic because, in addition to immature, crazy is one of the fave passive-aggressive insults that workplace bullies love to hurl at the target. Raise your hand if you've heard that one, and when do you hear it? When you finally have a response to being bullied. You happen to kind of, sort of like, not like it very much. In fact, your response to being bullied is the most psychologically sound thing that you can do. Workplace bullies passive-aggressively insult you with manipulative mind games, bang on office furniture, furnishings, and equipment to get your attention, invade and violate your physical and personal space, and even touch your body without your consent or permission, and shove the sexual parts of their bodies directly in your face at eye level, raise their voices at you, insult you, ridicule you by laughing at everything you say and do, harass you with abusive, aggressive, invasive, violating lines of questioning, disagree with absolutely everything that you say and do, objectify and stare at you and hold their noses every time they are in your presence, snub you, steal your ideas, words, jokes, and even work and personal items and possessions, fail to give you the necessary tools, materials, and resources to get the job done, destroy not only your work, but aspects of your personal life, are obsessed with not only your food, but absolutely everything about you, constantly eavesdrop on you and even stalk you inside and outside of the workplace, engage in vicious, mean-spirited gossip about you behind your back and even within earshot, spread slanderous rumors and lies about you, and gaslight you with false accusations that are so crazy-making they will make your head explode. But you're the one who's crazy. So that's a summary of a point I want to make about the mental and sometimes physical illnesses of workplace bullies as a cause of workplace bullying. If you'd like to read more, I've written an essay on workplace bullying. It's on my website. I include that information in the description. The reason I create this video series is to establish a forum where targets of workplace bullying can share their stories and experiences in a kind of support group. So you can know, number one, you're not crazy. Workplace bullying is real and your feelings are perfectly valid and justified. And number two, you're not alone. Unfortunately, countless others have experienced the same thing. So I look forward to reading your comments and I'll try to respond. Take care.